Flat Stanley and a Beast. Stanley Lambchop lived with his mother, his father, and his little brother Arthur. Stanley was 4 feet tall, about a foot wide, and half inch thick. He had been flat ever since a bulletin board fell on him. Being flat didn't stop Stanley from eating just as much as a regularly shaped boy. "Are the honey buns done?" he asked one summer afternoon. "Not yet," said Mrs. Lambchop. "I don't know why I'm baking. It's too hot today." "We'll cool you off," said Mr. Lambchop. "Boys, let's do the fan." Stanley flung himself on the floor. Arthur folded him up like an accordion. Then Mr. Lambchop grabbed Stanley by the ankles and flapped him back and forth. "Whoosh! Much better," said Mrs. Lambchop. Run outside and play, boys. I'll let you know when the buns are ready." "Let's go," said Stanley. "We can use our new slippery slide." Stanley loved a slippery slide. He always slid faster and faster, further than everyone else. Outside, Stanley and Arthur spotted Tom and Sam from down the street. "Want to slide?" called Arthur. "Sure," said Tom. "Let's play tag," said Sam after a while. "Okay," said Stanley. "You're it." Stanley loved tag too. He could bend and twist, so he was almost impossible to catch. "How about hide and seek?" Tom suggested next. That was Stanley's favorite game of all. He fit into the best hiding places. "This is perfect," Stanley thought, curling up inside the tire swing. "No one will ever find me." Then he heard a sound. "Eek!" someone cried. Stanley leaned out of the swing. "Found you," said Arthur. "No, you didn't," said Stanley. "Don't you hear the sound? I think someone's in trouble." The boys listened. "Eek!" came the cry again. Stanley and Arthur followed the sound of a hill. Sam hurried after them. "What's going on?" Sam asked. Before Stanley could answer, he heard another sound, an angry sound. Buzz! "Oh no," said Arthur. "It's Tom." Their friend stood like a statue, too scared to move. A swarm of bees buzzed around him. "I was hiding behind a tree," Tom squeaked. "I must have bumped a beehive. Eek!" "Arthur," yelled Stanley. "Let's do the fan." "Got it," Arthur said. Stanley flung himself on the grass. Arthur folded him up like an accordion. Then Arthur grabbed Stanley by the ankles and tried to flap him up and down, but he couldn't do it. Stanley was too heavy. Sam rushed over to help. 1, 2, 3, flap, Arthur called. Together they fanned Stanley with all their might. Whoosh! The blast of air blew the bees away, but not very far. The boys took off down the hill. The bees came after them. "They are catching up," Tom yelped. Then Stanley saw something, the slippery slide. Stanley let the others sit on top of him. Whizz! They sailed along and landed with a wet plop at the Lambchop's back door. The boys raced inside. So did the bees. "Here they come," moaned Arthur. "Eek!" squeaked Tom. But then the swarm served. "What? Where?" began Stanley. Then he gasped. "The honey buns!" Sure enough, the sweet, sticky buns were covered in sweet, sticky bees. "Oh dear," cried Mrs. Lambchop, walking into the kitchen. Then Mrs. Lambchop started to laugh. "It is too hot for warm buns away. Anyway, you know what we need, boy? Ice cream." The end.